everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Metroid Prime Remastered. Last time, well, you can see what we did last time on screen. Hey. This time, it's time to open some doors. And this.
Recording to logbook.
This is the lock type. I shrink back. Scan these now. Otherwise, you potentially will be waiting ages. Can't do anything here because we need the plasma beam. But yeah, I think that's annoying. In the original game, they actually had only one appearance, which was here. Jump all across. Both of those activated. Prepare for what I consider to be one of the most annoying quote unquote puzzles that we'll be dealing with for a while until we get the gravity. Gravity suit literally makes this puzzle not that bad. It's really just collecting everything. Though. Oh! Now you see why! And yes, we can't skip this cutscene. We do want to get through into that hatch. Especially before we get into that save area. Yeah, might as well. Oh, we can't scan the spider ball trap. Oh right, we might go down this way. I didn't go down that way. But yeah, we want to get that first, because it'll make this area a bit easier to deal with. It's not completely easier, but hey. Oh, Dodge up. Once you're up here, you should be fine as long as you don't get yourself flexed and get hit. There are only two paths because we can't get through there. Fire missile. Take a running strip. Jump. And a save room. Wait, what? Save? Haven't scanned the save. Save. Now with that, you want to try and keep a few missiles on you before we go in here. Charge up. This is Space Pirate. And we want to scan these this one because this one, the regular one turns. Normally, they don't pin you to the wall. But apparently... Oh boy! Remember these things for later. Necessary because, well, oh wait, actually this one, yeah, Project Titan Specimen is immobilized in Quarantine Cave. That is actually a reference to the next boss we'll be facing, the next proper boss. We do want to scan the map station because there's a limited number, and I want to scan anything that has a limited number of themselves. And lore. I'm an idiot. I keep always thinking I have to jump up here. These guys are, and yeah, warning, probably we'll never be using the combat lines here once we're through with this place. Scan the force field when you can, because you're effectively only three times. Recording to log book. Okay. Okay, is this the one? Okay. Elevator is operational. And the talk about Metroids now. We need to activate this, and I want to do this quickly because very useful information. It's just telling us about pirates finding Phazon. Okay. Alright, better scan these because you rarely see those deactive. But then again, you also rarely see these active. I love how it's tied to the music, but then just goes off beat. your projector. Showing us Talon IV's solar system. And the one thing that is very useful. First of all, Billiam. Or mine.
Recorded to logbook.
And this is Talon IV. The only one that we have natural data for. Or about this one. Zebes. Or Zeebs. Or whatever you want to call it. It's nice that while all they give all the planets information, which is fair, but I like how they gave Zebes and Talon IV data, because A, you're on Talon IV, it makes sense. But also, Zebes was Samus's home. First, break that open. Second of all, scan this for super missiles. Oh yeah, first beam combo, and the only required one. All the others aren't required. I'm getting them all though. And now, with this powerful attack, it uses 5 missiles. Using the power beam, press and hold ZR8 to charge, and press R to fire. We'll get to test this out soon. And it is as powerful as you think it is. Get a really good test for it. That was done pretty early, so let's continue on. Because we can't actually leave here yet. I'm going to switch back to power beam. Actually, no, we're going to keep it to the wave beam, because the wave beam will is still quite useful. Sky Pirates. I believe these kinds are the same. Yeah, the Sky Pirates. Just charge up and let them have it. Because otherwise they'll just be a nuisance. Thankfully, we only need to do that fight twice. Technically, you only need to do it once, but it makes things going through everything. It means getting the thing, the chosen artifact, much easier if you need it. However, the next room shows why we need power. You're probably probably just gonna scan me like, oh, da da da.
Recorded to logbook.
Oh yeah. Reconstruction of the Geoform 8187, codenamed Ridley, was recently completed after his defeat on Zevis. Command ordered a number of metagenic improvements for him. Progressive, we were able to implement these changes in a cycle. The metamorphosis was painful, but quite successful in the end. Early tests indicate a drastic increase of strength, mobility, and offensive capability. Cybernetic modules and armor and plating have been added as well. We believe our creation, now called Metarilly, will become our mainstay of our security force. A job he will certainly relish. And oh, he will. But it's not a Metroid game without Metroids. Well, I'm kind of wrong, but not completely. And this is a scan you have to do, because otherwise you can't continue. Talon Metroid. SR388 is the Metroid homeworld, mind you. Watch out, because it just blows into bits. Don't worry about losing any ammo. It is better to waste ammo on these guys than to try and deal with them like a regular person. Project Helix. We'll see what happens to Project Helix later. Probably nothing. How am I going to get into this? Oh wait, better check first, please.
Recorded to logbook.
Sadly, we don't have any hilarious data from the
recorded to logbook
pirates about trying to use Metroids for target practice. Yes, the pirates apparently did do that. Oh, right. There's one Metroid here. Yep. Get rid of it. Just bomb it. It's impossible. Turn into a cloud of... Assume his phase on. One missile to get this energy tank. I thought I had to power it and I was going to show. But no. And as you can see, there's actually some monsters here. I think these are actually. Yeah. These are actually some of the unused enemies. And some of them, I believe, are meant to be Metroids. Here are the ice beetles. Thank you. Sadly, we can't actually aggravate these Metroids. However, we won't need to. Another Talon Metroid. If you think this is a bad idea, don't worry, it is. Can't open it for that, we need another beam weapon. Prepare to meet our first proper visor. The verbal visor. However, and I forgot to scan it. Oh well. And power's out. On. Don't remove it. Deal with all the pirates on the ground floor, then move up after you switch to power beam. Power beam charge, and then slowly move to where the Talon Metroids are. Don't believe there is anything in the others. I'll try and pull it up. Nope. No. Okay. Slowly. You don't want to deal with Talon Metroids longer than you have to. One more set of Talon Metroids. And you may think, oh, this is easy. Yeah. Mind you, I made you save these missiles. They were for the Metroids. They weren't for the space pirates. Now imagine playing as blind and not knowing that you that Metroids could easily be beaten with get rid of that. Yeah. Expect to see more of those guys. Shadow pirate. A very terrible shadow pirate, but still a shadow pirate. Speaking of shadow pirates, I'm gonna try again, mate. Right. There's that. Let's get to that. You better do this when it's light on. Granted, yeah, now I remember why I missed this one. Because I was like, eh, I'll come back when the power turns on. It never does. The world is not at peace. The universe is not at peace. Anyways, now I've got 40 missiles. We might actually probably end up getting better than my actual save. So just ignore them. Put on the thermal visor again. Alright. And just haul. Ignore the enemies for now. Want to save. Because getting out can be a bit of a problem. We don't want to take more damage than we need to, so kind of. So if we can save, we can avoid having to take the longest way there. Out. Oh my god. I just duck out of there. If the enemy can't hold you, okay, just might as well just hook it. Turn off the thermal visor when you get out. Or just before you go, before you go into the next, to try and check for what's going on in the next room, switch the power beam, and save again. Because you don't want to go back through there if you don't, when you don't have to. Granted, I think minus one thing, we've cleared out that room, that area of Pandrana Drift. We will have to return because, like I said, There is something there. We do have to go through and get the chosen artifact. I keep going to call it something else, but that's the second game. Okay. Ignore that. And now we go into the quarantine cave and see a pile of rocks. We can't scan them, but it's scannable. a rock. The rocks are alive. Meet the boss of Vandrana Drifts, Fardis. Scan Fardis. Fardis, an animated sentient creature of stone, short phase of radiation. Yeah, this is sort of a lie. But yeah, locking on is going to be helpful, but you need the thermal vitality. Fardis wasn't actually meant to be the boss of Vandrana Drifts. That was actually to a primate-like boss that got cut partly because they didn't get time to actually deal with it. Like, find out what to give it and all that and make sure that it was really working. But the other... Another reason why is because they didn't feel like it fit the game or the Metroid series. So Fardis lost its boss status of Magmor Caves to gain boss status here. Yeah, this does mean Magmor Caves is the only area that doesn't have a boss fight or a complete town. All the other areas do have boss fights though, so yeah. Yeah. This is when you're gonna be using the thermal visor even when you can't attack him. Because yeah, you won't die afterward. And this is why I'm saying you save your this phase. You won't get much time to see him. But that don't matter when he's just go down in one hit. Well, hit not hit exactly, but it's fun. Next is the big part. He would potentially blow. He did it again! Really? He did it again. gets to block twice. Oh my god. Artists. Stop. They're not fun to do when you're doing this. They're not fun to fight when you're doing this. Oh my gosh! That's all he's done. It's not fun because I can't do anything with me until I get blinded. And Fardus gives us the spider ball. Meet probably one of the most useful upgrades for a while. Sadly, there isn't much to it, because the second game expanded on this, and honestly, the second game did some really cool stuff with it. But we can't do any more than just going up here. Because that grapple point. Yes, now it reminds us about those again. I don't care. And we're at a different point. We can go up there. But yeah, there's an ice beam door. So instead, we're gonna go down here. And if I'm remembering what door this is behind, we will end up just saving. Yep, we will be. Because this save room door over here, we might as well save. Quite a long episode. But next time, we're going to get another combo weapon. Of course, we're still going to get a bit of energy, we're going to get maybe a rock or two, and we're probably going to face since we don't have the weapon that makes them really easy to beat. I'll see you then. Xeno and Zuma, signing out. I'm not looking forward to fighting those things, if you know who I'm meaning.